Okay, I just want to do a quick one on the wrong way to tie. I was about to take Mr. T out for a quick ride, and I noticed I forgot and left the water on in another area. So what I did, since if you watch how to tie a rope, I've got his reins tied up. I just pulled his reins over his head and did a quick tie here, just basically to pull this through here. And I just wanted to stick something through here to stop it from pulling back. So all I did was kind of hang my brush on there. So now if Mr. T pulls, he'll pull this thing in here. Now this could scare him. This isn't a good tie. This is a temporary tie. This is a tie where I have him in my sight to where I know he's local. I'm just walking back, you know, a few feet away. I'm going to be gone for a few seconds to turn off some water. So it's not what I would consider a good tie. Is it effective? Yeah, it just holds him for a second. Could I have hobbled him up? Yeah. Could I have let him go? Yeah, he might have ran off to go play with horses. I just wanted to kind of secure him up. Would you train a horse to tie this way? No, because this would scare a horse. There's a plastic bag here that's flapping around, and every time it blows, Mr. T kind of is like, hey, is that thing coming to get me? So is this a good tie? No. Is it effective? Yeah. Could I just tie a slip knot? Yeah. Would I leave him here? Oh, here comes trouble. He was in there raiding somebody's stall. Don't come over here and cause trouble, boy. I know. What are you doing? What are you doing? I'm trying to show him how to tie Mr. T wrong. You're going to come over and try to make him escape and cause problems. I know. You're a good boy. I know. We're going to go play. All right, so I'm going to go ride Mr. T around, let Buddy run around with us. Maybe I'll pull this camera out. It's kind of hard to stay on. But anyway, just a real quick one on, you know, thinking outside the box. Would somebody see this and go, man, this guy's crazy. He should never, never, never. Remember, never, always. Look, this is a pretty good tie. It's a secure tie. Would you want to do it with a new speaker horse that's going to spook every time this does this? No. If you got a horse that's pulling and testing, will it flop it out? Yeah. But will it hold him just for temporary so I can go turn off some water? Sure. That's the advantage of having a rope halter. When you ride in a rope halter, you can tie your horse. He's used to being tied in it. If he's tied correctly, he's not going to pull. He's not going to strain. You're not going to have to worry about him pulling. You know, can you tie him to something that he can pull away? Yeah. Would I tie him to a plastic chair? Absolutely not. Because even the wind could blow it over and that would scare him. Then he'd start running and then he'd think the chair was chasing him and he would panic and run through a fence and break a leg or run off a cliff. I wouldn't want to time something here. If he gets away, the worst thing that's going to happen is this rope's going to either unhook on the little brush there, curry comb, or it's going to snap the little cheap, these little things right here. People go, oh, a horse can't break that. Well, you're crazy. They can break it. They break them all the time. These are cheap cast iron and they'll snap if a horse pulls hard enough. But those are the two worst things that can happen. Then he's got his reins and he runs off. So again, when you're tying, looking at the big picture, there's a phrase in law enforcement called totality of the circumstances. They use it in court, they use it in police work. You have to look at the big picture. That's why when people want to ask one simple question, how do you tie, there's not a right answer. It depends on the totality of the circumstances. How good is your horse trained? Are there any new variables in there? Are there loose horses? How tight is your secure point? Should you never tie to an insecure secure? Yeah, I guess you should say you never want your horse to learn, but after years and your horse knows a lot to give pressure, you can tie him to things and he gets away and it's not the end of the world. You just tie him another point and he doesn't try anymore. Has Mr. T gotten away sometimes when Buddy unties him? Yeah. Does that mean he's going to pull all the time? No. So again, totality of the circumstances, looking at everything, looking at the big picture. I'm walking away for a few minutes. I'm here. I'm observing. Would I tie my horse the same way if I'm out camping and I'm going to leave for 2 hours? Or would I tie him the same way as if I'm sitting around a campfire where I can keep an eye on him? Yeah, those are different. I don't have to tie him the exact same way. So being flexible, again, the advantages of using a rope halter to ride because you can tie your horse easy. I'm being lazy. I'm taking a shortcut. That's normally bad. Would I recommend this? No. Does it hurt to do it every once in a while? Sure. There's no absolutes in horse training. When you hear these people saying absolute, never, always, respect my space, always, never let a horse, never, never, never let your horse eat, never tie your... When you hear all those, you know that people aren't flexible and they don't really have knowledge. What they're doing is they're repeating what they were told because of their limited knowledge. So as you're advancing in your horsemanship, you can try different things, you can do different things. You realize that if there's going to be trouble, how big is the trouble going to be? Are you going to be close? Is it a learning experience? And you take all those factors into consideration and you look at the totality of the circumstances and then you decide what you're going to do. So anyway, save the hate mail for that's a bad tie and I'm setting my horse up to fail and all that. I know all that. I'm making a point. People take shortcuts. I take shortcuts. But again, it's How far? How long? How close? Is he in my sight? Can I help him if it gets in trouble? All these factors have to go in when you do things with horses. Okay, yeah, with the experience of the horse, if Mr. T panics, can I undo it? How good am I in my horsemanship that I know that if I make a mistake, I'm not going to be in a panic and go, oh my God, now I'll never be able to train my horse. That's the mindset of these people that get these horses that are abused. Oh, my horse was abused. He'll never trust anybody. I made a mistake. Now my horse, my horse broke free so I can never tie my horse. My horse stepped on his lead rope so I can never let the lead rope drop. And you get all these panicking, weirdo, freakazoid things out there. Buddy? All right, we'll end that there. Hope that helps. Mr. T, you're a good old boy. I know you are.